अस्सलाम वालेकुम क्लास, गुड मॉर्निंग एंड हाउ आर यू? आई होप यू ऑल आर फाइन. ओके, आवर टुडेज टॉपिक इज़ कैन, द यूज़ ऑफ कैन, कुड एंड मस्ट. ओके, आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द रीडिंग. वी यूज़ कैन, ओके, वी यूज़ कैन टू से दैट समथिंग इज़ पॉसिबल और अलाउड और दैट समबडी हैज़ द अबिलिटी टू डू समथिंग. We use can and infinitive. What is infinitive? Infinitive usually begin with the word to. Okay, infinitive usually start with the word to. For example, to read, to run, etc. Okay, there we use can and do or can plus see. We can see the lake from our hotel. I don't have a pen, you can use mine. Okay, there we are going to learn the use of can, could and must. In this sentence we are going to learn the use of can. We can see the lake from our hotel. I don't have a pen, you can use mine. Can you speak any foreign languages? I can come and see you tomorrow if you like. The word dream can be a noun or a pronoun. Okay, the negative is cannot. The negative form of can is cannot. I am afraid I cannot come to the party on Friday. Next step is, you can say that somebody is able to do something, but can is more usual. For example, we are able to see the lake from our hotel, but can has only two form, present form and past form. For example, can is present form and could is past form. But sometimes it is necessary to use be able to. Okay, sometimes we use be able to, the use of be able to and the use of can and the use of could. For example, I cannot sleep. When we use be able to, there is a sentence, I have been able to sleep recently, and Tom might be able to कम टमोरो. माइट का यूज़ हम बाद में पढ़ेंगे, ठीक है. एंड देर इज़ अनदर एग्जाम्पल अबाउट कैन. टॉम कैन कम टमोरो एंड देर इज़ यूज़ ऑफ बी एबल टू. टॉम माइट बी एबल टू कम टमोरो. एंड कुड, द यूज़ ऑफ कुड. समटाइम कुड इज़ द पास्ट ऑफ कैन. जैसे कि हमने ऊपर पढ़ा है, क्या था, कैन जो है वो प्रेजेंट फॉर्म है और कुड पास्ट फॉर्म है, ठीक है. कैन की पास्ट फॉर्म होती है कुड. और यहाँ पे हम क्या पढ़ने जा रहे हैं, हम कुड का यूज़ पढ़ने जा रहे हैं. वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट द यूज़ ऑफ कुड. समटाइम्स कुड इज़ द पास्ट ऑफ कैन. वी यूज़ कुड स्पेशली विद सी, हेयर, स्मेल, टेस्ट, फील, रिमेंबर एंड अंडरस्टैंड. देर आर सम एग्जाम्पल्स. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, वी हैड अ लवली रूम इन द होटल, वी कुड सी द लेक. Past form, as soon as I walked in the room, I could smell gas. Okay, these are past sentences. As soon as I walked into the room, I could smell eggs. I was sitting at the back of the theater and couldn't hear very well. Okay, we also use could to say that somebody had the general ability or permission to do something. For example, my grandfather could speak 5 languages. We are totally free. We could do what we want. We are allowed to do. Use of could to do and use of could, use of can. Today we are going to learn the use. Okay, next step is could and was able to. In past sentences we can use were, was, okay, and second form ed in simple past sentences. We use could for general abilities. When we use could for general abilities. But if you want to say that somebody did something in a specific situation, we use was or were and were able to or manage to, not could. We use could in general abilities, okay? And when, if you want to say that somebody did something in a specific situation, you can use their was. You must use their was, were able to or managed to. For example, ऐसी सिचुएशन में आप क्या करोगे, आप पास्ट सेंटेंसेस का यूज़ कर रहे हो, पास्ट सेंटेंस तो डेफिनेटली यूज़ कर रहे हो, तो वहाँ पे आप सिंपल सेंटेंसेस में सेकंड फॉर्म यूज़ करते हो, ऐसे ही है ना. एंड नेक्स्ट जाके आप क्या करते हो, वाज और वर का यूज़ आप कर रहे हो, वहाँ पे आप कुड का यूज़ नहीं करोगे स्पेसिफिक सिचुएशन में, जहाँ पे स्पेसिफिक सिचुएशन हो. और जनरल एबिलिटीज़ का जहाँ पे, वहाँ पे आप क्या यूज़ करो, आप कुड का यूज़ करो. द फायर स्प्रेड थ्रू द बिल्डिंग वेरी क्विकली. But fortunately, everybody was able to escape or managed to escape, not could escape. Okay? In specific situation, you can say there, the fire spread through the building very quickly. But fortunately, everybody was able to escape or managed to escape. In specific situation, we didn't know where David was, but we managed to find, or we were able to find him in the end. Not could find or could find. We use there managed to find or were able to find in specific situations. Okay, there is comparison of both. Jack was an excellent tennis player when he was younger. He could beat anybody. He had the general ability to beat anybody. We use their could because he had the general ability to beat anybody. Jack and Andy played a match yesterday. Andy played well, but Jack managed to beat him. He managed to beat him in this time. Okay. The negative couldn't or could not is possible in all situations. My grandfather could not swim. He looked for David everywhere, but he couldn't find him. Okay. This is the use of can and could. Okay, next, could do and could have. We use could in a number of ways. Sometimes could is the past of can. Listen, I can hear something. This is the present form. And in past form or in past sentences, we use could. For example, I listened, ed. I listened, I could hear something. This is a past sentence. But could is not only used in this way. We also use could to talk about possible action now or in the future. Now, present or in the future, especially to make suggestions. For example, we do tonight. We could go to the cinema. What shall we do tonight? We could go to the cinema in future. Okay, we also use could in this situation. When we go to the Paris next month, you could stay with Sarah. Yes, I suppose I could. Can is also possible in this sentences. We can go to the cinema, etc. For example, could is less sure than can. when we are less sure about the situation, we use could, and when we are sure about the situation, we use their can. For example, we also use could, not can, for actions that were not realistic. For example, we also use could, not can, for action that was not realistic. For example, I am so tired, I could sleep for a week. Not, I can sleep for a week, I could sleep, because we are not sure about that situation, or this is not a realistic thing, this is not a realistic situation. We can't sleep for a week. He just supposed that I could sleep for a week because I am too much tired. I'm so tired. That's why he used their could. We use their could. I could sleep for a week. This is not a realistic situation. This is an unrealistic situation. Okay, comparison can and could. I can stay with Sarah when I go to Paris. I can stay. This is a realistic situation, or sure. He is sure about his stay, that where I can stay. I can stay with Sarah when I go to the Paris. Maybe I could stay with Sarah. Maybe means suppose, or maybe, perhaps, not sure, maybe I could stay with Sarah when I go to Paris. This is a possible but less sure. Maybe, perhaps. This is a wonderful place. I could stay here forever. Unrealistic. You can't stay on one place forever. This is a wonderful place. I could stay here forever. Okay, next, we also use could, not can, to say that something or situation or happening is possible now or in a future. The meaning is similar to might or may. The meaning are similar of might and may, but situation are different where we use might or may. Situation will be different, but meaning will be same, may or might. For example, the story could be true, but I don't think it is. Not can be true. The story could be true, but I don't think it is. I don't know what time Lisa is coming. She could get here at any time, because he's less sure about. She's less sure. Less sure about Lisa. Comparison can and could. There are two examples. The weather can change very quickly in the mountains. In general way, we use can in a general way. The weather is nice now, but it could change. The weather now, not in a general specific condition. We use could have done to talk about the past. Comparison either. I am so tired, I could sleep for a week. Now, present. I'm so tired, I could sleep for a week. I was so tired, I could have slept for a week. Past, in past sentence, how we use could have, or these type of uses in the past sentences. The situation is bad, but I could be worse. The situation was bad. First clause in this example, first clause is in present form and second clause in past form, but in second situation he uses past sentence in both clauses. The situation was bad, but I could have been worse. Okay, sometime could have happening. It was possible but did not happen. Sometime could have happened. It was possible but didn't happen. Possible hota hai, lekin didn't happen, but did not happen. Why did you stay at a hotel when you were in Paris, you could have stayed with Sarah. You didn't stay with her. David was lucky. He could have hurt him when he fell, but he's okay. Okay, next up is the use of must and can't. You can see on your books, you can concern with your books. Okay, you can see must to say that you believe something is certain. You can use must, the word must, to say that you believe something is certain. You have been traveling all day. You must be tired. Traveling is tiring and you have been traveling all day. So you must be tired. Okay, the use of must. How can you use must in your sentences? So you can concern with your book. Joe is a hard worker. Joe, you must be joking. He does not do anything. Okay, next is, fourth sentence. I'm going to read the fourth sentence. I am sure Shelley give me her address. I must have it somewhere. Okay, you can use can't to say that you believe something is not possible. Okay, I'm going to again read. You can use the use of must to say that you believe something is certain. And in the way where you use can't, you can use can't say that you believe something is not possible, certain and not possible. You have just had lunch. You cannot be hungry already. You have just had lunch. You cannot be hungry already. People are not normally hungry just after eating a meal. You have just eaten, so you can't be hungry. They have not lived here for very long. You cannot know many people. Okay, study of the structure, I, you, he, etc. Must and can't be, the use of be tired, be hungry, at work, etc. Be doing, going, joking. You can use do get and no, etc. The use of be, doing, tired, do, etc. Okay, for the past we use must have done and must have done. Study this example. There is nobody at the home. They must have gone out. Okay, for example, there is nobody at the home. They must have gone out, and their conversation is Martin and Lucy were standing at the situation. Situation is Martin and Lucy are standing at the door of their friend's house. They have rung the doorbell twice, but nobody has answered. Lucy says they must have gone out. They must have gone out means action have been done. Action have been done. Actions have been done. Okay, they must have gone out. For example, we used to live very near to the motorway. Did you? I must have been noisy. It must have been noisy. Definitely, it must have been noisy because they are living in the near of the motorway. I have lost one of my gloves. You must have dropped it somewhere. Sure about something. When we sure about something, you or in possible situation. Sarah has not connected me. She cannot have got my message. Tom walked into a wall. He cannot have been looking where he was going. He cannot have been looking where he was gone. I, you, he, etc. must and can't have been or have been doing, going, have been, gone, got, no, etc. You can use couldn't have instead of can't have. You can use the comparison in both uses could and can, and you can use both uses in different situation, like Sarah couldn't have got my message, Tom couldn't have been looking where he was going. These are also uses. Okay, the end. This is our this was our today's class or lecture. Okay students, you can see the exercise in your books, so you must fill it. I will check it soon. Okay class, Allah Hafiz.